As you might know, I'm Petter Reinholdsen, one of the guys that started this School Linux project, and I've been the technical coordinator most of the time. I'm going to give a slight update on the status of School Linux as we see it today, and hopefully we'll get the few remaining issues fixed this weekend or next few weeks. Next slide, please. So School Linux, as Knut already told you, is used all over the place. We have development teams quite a few places already. The German and French team already gave their introduction, so I'll mention the Greece team with Markos Konstantinos in the lead, funded by the Greece government, trying to make an office distribution based on School Linux, taking the network architecture of School Linux, taking out all the educational software and keeping the office tools in School Linux. We haven't seen the result yet, but they've just started, so I'm quite curious how that will go. We have approximately 890 packages, I think, on the CV, 890 perhaps, and most of them are already in Debian. We released the video version with approximately 1,000 packages, and approximately, I think it was like 50 of them were missing in Debian. Now we managed to get that number down to about 10 packages, and we're trying to get it down to zero. We took over the Debian EDU sub-project a few years ago, which was started by Raphael Herzog in France, and he ran out of time, so it was dormant for a few years, I think, and we decided to revitalize it and take over. We released the Woody version of School Linux in 2004, and we're working to get the Sarge-based version ready for the next release. And as I said, we are a Debian project. We are trying to get everything into Debian because that gives us quite a few extra advantages. Next slide, please. We want to have as few special packages as possible because it, every special packet increases our maintenance load, and we do not have the manpower, and we do not really want the manpower to maintain a parallel distribution. With the new Sarge-based version, we will move to a new KDE. We will make it possible to use a newer kernel. We have all the translations available for Debian, which is, I think, like 30 languages for the installation and for KDE and all the, well, quite a lot of the user applications. Of course, there are a few applications still missing translations. There's quite a lot of other new stuff in there. I didn't put up the complete list, so I just give a few highlights. Next slide, please. So, I want to stress this again. We need to get everything we are working on into Debian, and we need to make sure that packages we need in Debian stay supported in Debian. And recently, the Webmin, all the Webmin packages in Debian was thrown out, which is rather sad, because we have been deploying and teaching people, schools, how to use Webmin to administrate their systems, and Debian packages have been like rotting for 2 years with no one maintaining them properly. And finally, the maintainer decided enough is enough and asked the archive maintainers in Debian to remove Webmin. So from last week, I think there's no more Webmin packages in Debian. And why do we want the packages in Debian? Because it increases quality, not on its own, of course, but to get packages into Debian, they have to have a certain quality, they have to follow Debian policy, and if they follow Debian policy, it's possible to upgrade them. It's the packages will be integrated with the other packages, they will work out of the box, everything will be very nicely integrated with the whole Debian the system, and that increases quality of a packet. We also get larger visibility of the packet, more testers, more users, a lot of developers looking into the packet if it has built problem on some strange architecture. It's probably a bug in the source and not something to be ignored. We also get security fixes from the security team in Debian, so we do not have to provide security patches ourselves. That reduces our workload. And we also get to use the Debian infrastructure to maintain the packet and keep track of bugs and all that stuff. And we also try to push our changes back into what the Debian community normally calls upstream, which I guess is an image of how hard it is to get stuff in there. But the point is that when we do KDE translations, we give it to the KDE project, and after a while it shows up in the Debian packages, the Red Hat packages, the Fedora packages, the SUSE packages, and all the other distributions, of course. And our goal is the Debian packages, but putting them into the KDE project instead of putting them into the Debian project, make sure that we increase the visibility of the translations and all the changes we do. And we also make sure that the next version of the packet includes them as well, so we don't have to redo the effort to put it back into the packet every time there is a new release. Yeah, I mentioned the Webmin issue. There's an Aliot project to maintain the Webmin, and Yardar, I think his name is, an Indian Debian developer who was trying to maintain Webmin for a few years, asking for someone to take over for a few years, and then finally discovering that the team he had founded on Aliot didn't really consist of anyone but himself. And then decided to pull the plug. So there is a project there, and the framework to do a team development and maintenance of the packet is there, but it needs some team members to actually be a working team. The French team has several educational packages lined up to get into the distribution, but they are not in Debian yet. We need to work together to get them ready. And I suspect there is a lot of hard work left before they are policy compliant and ready to go into Debian, and I hope we can get that done. The boot system in Debian Edge changed a few months ago to speed up the installation and reduce the amount of boots required to get the installed system up and running. They moved all the installation hooks from one subsystem to the other, and we used to use the old hooks, which are no longer there. So we need to rewrite our stuff to use the Debian installer hooks instead of the base config hooks, because base config is being removed. Okay.
But isn't this a post-Sarge item? Now we concentrate on Debian School Linux for Sarge.
Yes.
And this will later work.
This will be a take effect when we will go for Edge, but we need to pay attention, and if we do modifications to the boot or the installation system, we should try to make it work for Edge too. So we should be aware of the issue. Next slide. Next slide. We recently replaced LTSP from a version with ripped out Red Hat release, basically, with a few modifications to a version based on Debian packages. This saved approximately 50 megabytes on the CD, giving space for more user applications, but it also gave us a slower boot of the clients and requiring more memory. And with the new encrypted connections between the client and the server, the login takes quite a long time as well. We will have to find a way to solve this. There's also sound support being worked on. The new version of LTSP is a co-production of Ubuntu and Debian. we are working together with the people in Ubuntu developing LTSP, and they have already fixed part of these problems. We just need to pull them back into Debian. Of course, when I say just, it's nothing but hard work left to do. There's no like rocket science research project. You just have to sit down and spend weeks and weeks to fix it. We lost quite a few user applications from the CD between the Ruby and the South version because all the patches increased in size when the compiler changed. That's quite annoying. I think they became like 30% larger, all the patches.
That's true.
And yeah, we need to find a way to select the good packages because at the moment we probably have a few things on the CD that's not being used and is not really fit for use in the school. Of course we do have quite a few good applications, but we could have more of them, or we could at least get other applications if we could identify the cruft and get rid of it. And that's when I will take a detour and demonstrate the Debian EDU popularity contest. Click on the link. One way to help us find out what applications are actually used in schools is to install the popularity contest packet and configure it to report the packages used to our system. This is 39 machines reporting their application usage. And if you have a look at the... go for the unknown vote link.
Yeah.
This one. This showed the list of non-Debian packages being used the last week in one of the 39 machines reporting to popularity contest. LTSP Core i386 is the old LTSP packet. Not too surprising that it's quite a that it has quite a lot of users. AcroReader, the PDF reader, Java, blah, blah, Phoenix, yeah. So these packages we should try to get into Debian, and I've been spending quite a lot of time trying to get free Java versions up to speed to be able to replace the 7 Java, which is, because of the license, non-free. Better PDF reader, obviously, is something people want. We need to look into that. LTSP we are working on. Phoenix, I know Tolle Foghen and a few others are working on getting into Debian. And players are pain in the ass. All the others we should look into. And the point is that if you are using a packet which you want to have on the school Linux CD, if it doesn't show up here, it will probably never get there. So if you want it to show up on the CD, make sure you run popularity contest and report your used packages, and then we will track them and try to figure out how to get them into Debian. Of course, we also use the same popularity contest list for the Debian packages to decide which will go into the CD and which will be thrown out. Go back if you want, back to the slides.
No,
seem to be on the right track. I guess it's the wireless network being very slow down there. Other issues left to be fixed. There is a few of the services in the... I think you went one too far.
What is it, Opera?
That's Opera.
No, doesn't like us.
It's in the history. Why the hell?
I don't know. You work there, you should know.
Yeah.
Anyway, there is some of the services that are not working correctly at the moment. We have the monitoring system, the Nagios configuration is not perfect, to put it that way. F11 to get to full screen mode.
F11 functions key.
And page down if you have some space.
Back one.
Yes. NTP I think was fixed yesterday or today.
Yeah.
Nagios needs more work to be able to monitor all the services we are installing. Email system, I'm not sure if that's working correctly at the moment. And we are looking into and testing all the other services to make sure they are correctly configured. Also working on the diskless workstations that will not be included in the default installation, but we hope to have a script provided so you can convert a normal LTSP client into a diskless workstation. The difference between an LTSP client and a diskless workstation is that the thin client runs everything on the server, while a diskless workstation runs everything on the client. But they all use the same file system over the net and behave as a no maintenance replacement unit. But you get USB support, you get video, you can display videos as long as you have a fast enough client, because it doesn't decompress on the server and try to push it back on the network. More stuff is done locally on the client. It's already implemented, but we need to do more testing before it's ready to work out of the box. Next slide. One problem that keeps coming up is the configuration. And the task of the School Linux project is to provide answers to all the questions the users and the administrators don't want to see. They don't want to spend time figuring out which is the best foo feature around. They just want something that works. So we make the tough decisions for the other, for the users. We hide complexity. And I know quite a few developers prefer to leave the decision making to the administrator of a local machine, which is fine with me, but it's not the thing we are providing. So we are working to make the packages in Debian pre-configurable, meaning that we can set the configuration at install time and make sure this work across upgrades, and hopefully also after, if you do install packages after the first installation. The way we do this at the moment is using devconf preceding, which is providing answers to the questions the installation system would ask during installation, and make sure the packages pick them up at installation time and do the right thing. That's the preferred way of doing it, but not all the packages we want to configure support this. We also rewrite configuration files during or after the packages are installed. This breaks upgrades. We provide replacement configuration files. This might break upgrades. And we also provide overloaded configuration, which works perfectly for some packages, not all packages. KDE, for example, we make some hooks making sure that KDE will look in an extra directory for configuration, and we provide a lot of files in that directory to set up email configuration, turn off the warning that some device is missing, or thin clients and stuff like that. One way to solve it is going for multi-level configuration, but that needs to go through upstream. We have to change the behavior of the application itself to get that to work. So that's the long way. The short way might be this CDD toolkit, custom Debian distribution toolkit being developed by Sergio in Spain. It's a gross hack, but it kind of solved the problem by making sure that before the packages are upgraded, the old files from the packet is reinserted in the old place, then the package is upgraded, and when the package is upgraded, the files are removed and our files are put back in the place we want them. So it's hooking into the installation system of packages, and it seems to be working, but there's got to be a better way. So there's quite a few things going on, and hopefully middle of February I'm going to Malaga to talk to Sergio and a few other developers in custom Debian community to see if we can come up with better solutions to these and other issues. Yeah. Next slide. Questions?
Did you know that I talked to Sergio.
he told me he was going to do a presentation on it in Malaga. So, I don't know the status of it. No. Any other questions? No. Then I think we should get back to work.
Yeah. Peter, thank you very much. I have to announce another topic of our program at 14 o'clock. We will start a presentation done by this guy there. Yeah? And he will present the German situation in school and free software. That's more from a political point of view. And so it's interest for the PR stuff and this NPR things involve people from their different teams are here. So now I wish the developers, sorry?
Sorry, but for the presentation of Mr. Trollos, it's very important that the developers are present because Mr. Trollos will present some technical things and some other things which should be changed in school Linux to use it in schools, and I think the developers have to listen.
Well, this is one opinion. I don't know. You want to to tell something? What you want to present? It's better you do it by yourself than I. And then, well, I want to have enough time for the developers to fix the bugs. This is my main goal. So please decide what is important.
Okay. It's a special presentation from the German view of life, because in Germany some things are gone in other ways than in Norway, because we have not so much support from the ministries, and therefore because we are 82 million people and Norway is a little smaller, and so the administration in Germany is much bigger, and we have in the top level of the federal administration, we have a ministry for education, and we have 16 countries. Every country has a ministry of administration, so there something goes wrong. And how is the real situation in Germany in schools? If you want to know something about that, and some things you have to do on school Linux, because you can change the situation because of the excellent concepts, you could listen to my presentation. Thank you.
So, ja, thank you very much. Ja, danke fürs Zuhören und ich würde sagen, die Pause ist jetzt verdient. Schauen Sie rum und ja, viel Spaß beim Arbeiten.
Wann geht's weiter?
14 Uhr mit diesem Vortrag.
Okay.
14:30 ist dann der nächste Vortrag. Wir haben den Vortrag von Herrn Trollis davor geschoben.
Ah.
Okay?